Here's your new desk, kid. You're on traffic. The hot sheet is posted here, next to the map.
What's his problem?
That's Biggs. He's an institution.
So this is what all the fuss is about. Why couldn't they build a freeway that goes past my place?
They haven't even approved the money yet, kid. The bond issue won't be till December. It'll be years before any of this will happen. Here's your new partner, Stefan Bekowsky.
I've heard all about you, Phelps. You go easy on me and let me earn the odd citation, and maybe we'll get along fine. I'm here to learn, Detective.
Oh, he's an intense one, isn't he, Mel?
He's intense.
The newly minted detective here, Cole Phelps.
Hi, Phelps. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I could spend a little time basking in reflected glory, make a change from busting hookers and dope fiends.
Who was that, Commander?
Roy Earle, chief detective and advice.
Do they all dress like movie stars?
Well, Roy is a movie star. And the whole of the seedy side of L.A. is his audience.
What is that supposed to mean?
Stick with me, kid. You'll find out.
And now some housekeeping. Warm Central Division welcome for Detective Cole Phelps. Some of you guys may know Phelps. He's the cop who broke the jewelry store murder. Stand up and take a bow, Phelps.
If it's all right with
That's
you, sir.
That's an order, Phelps.
Ooh.
Quiet, please. Phelps is one of only two serving LAPD officers who received the Silver Star during the war. You really gave it those lousy Japanese, eh, Phelps?
I did my best, Captain.
Why, you war hero is always so modest. I've partnered Phelps with everybody's favorite Pole, Stefan Bekowsky.
Hope you like work, kid. Bekowsky sure as hell doesn't.
Well, that's why we have partners, right?
Okay, can it, guys. Stick with Bekowsky. He's a good cop. He knows traffic inside now. I'm going to start you out with one case. You do okay, I'll give you a couple more. You screw up, you'll be rousing vagrants and running license plates. Now get down to the P.E. Freight Depot, 6th and Alameda. A patrolman called in a suspicious vehicle. Signs of foul play. See what you can find out.
Come on, Phelps.
He was in the bathtub, and he'd taken one of his fingers.
California to be a secretary.
They really pushed you too quick, didn't they? 6 years on patrol before I got this desk. You were here in 5 minutes.
What do you want me to say? I didn't ask for any favors.
Two peanuts are walking down the street. One was assault, sir. Only if I guarantee he walks.
Isn't he the cop who won a medal in solving all the cases?
You know this place?
Sure. Near the old gas works and Signo Depot in the warehouse district. I'll direct.
Let's turn, shall we, during this brief intermission to an interesting situation. You wake up in the morning feeling weak. It could be a deficiency of iron you need for healthy blood.
All units of 459 just occurred at 6th and Saris. Any unit to handle, code 2 identified.
So, tell me a little about yourself, Phelps. Are we friends now, Bekowsky? We have to work together. Don't be so touchy. I grew up in San Francisco. My father was in shipping. Went to college in Stanford. Did 2 years ROTC before Reno CS at Camp Elliott. Shipped out in early 45 as a first lieutenant. Fought in the Okinawa campaign. I was wounded. Shipped back home. Did a year on the beat. So you won the Silver Star. I don't want to talk about it. Now let me get this straight. You single-handedly killed 40 Japs on this hill in Okinawa.
No. You were up there all night, draped in the flag, knife between your teeth, gun at the ready.
Finished? The Emperor Hirohito himself leading the charge against you.
I did my part, Bekowsky. What did you do?
I kept the streets of L.A. safe for the people.
Yeah. Now I get it. Unfit for service.
No, fuck you, Phelps. I earned a bravery citation during the Zuta riots.
Sounds like you had it rough.
I did my job.
No one is saying you didn't.
I did 6 years as a patrolman.
That's the third time you've told me.
You take December.
Take the next right.
Straight through at the next junction.
Take the next left.
Right through.
Cross over, keep going straight.
Don't give me three guesses. One.
Right up ahead. You need to take the next left.
Just occurred at 6th and Saris. Any unit to handle, code 2 identified.
Go straight through here. Take the next left.
Broadcasting from Los Angeles, California. This is KTI Radio. And now, news from Washington.
Polish girls arrive at Montreal, Canada in a post-war labor experiment by a Canadian industrialist. The girls are part of a group of 100 who will work in a rayon mill at Saint-Georges-de-Beauce, where they will receive the Dominion's minimum wage of $12 a week. The displaced girls, brought from Frankfurt, will be taught the rayon spinning process.
That you, Bekowsky? Go on through. Parking lot straight ahead.
I need to get back to work, officer.
The detectives are here now. You repeat to them what you told me.
I did the right thing by calling this in. I'm just a working stiff.
Just give them your story and you'll be all right.
This is your first case, Phelps. It's okay to admit it if you're stumped. If you don't know what to do next, just come talk to me and we'll see what we can figure out.
Thanks, Stefan. You're okay.
Officer Hart.
Phelps, traffic. What have you got?
Abandoned car, probably stolen. The solid citizen is Nate Wilkie. He called it in.
What gives with the coroner?
There's blood all over the interior. Someone's copped a full Broderick, but no stiff as yet.
We have an owner for the car?
The car is registered to an Adrian Black, just north of Bunker Hill.
All right, we'll take a look around.
I'll keep Mr. Wilkie talking, but don't make him wait too long. He's the restless type.
Nice day for it.
How long are you gonna keep me here, sir?
I better get back.
How's the world looking?
Oh, where's the same two of you find? How about you?
I've got a mystery sample waiting at the lab.
Victim looks to have lost a lot of blood.
Thank you.
Happier times, I guess. Thirty-two years old, married. Sounds like an average guy. What was he doing out here? Stenzel glasses. Home repaired by the look of it. Brand name might give us something to go on.
I've got friends. How about you? I'd talk to you.
Doc? Detective Phelps. What have we got?
A lot of blood for a blunt force injury. Victim must be in a very bad way.
Any sign of the guy?
Not unless he's in the trunk of the car.
I don't think so. Mr. F. Morgan picked up a live pig yesterday?
Seems irrelevant.
Sir, I'm Detective Phelps.
Name's Nate Wilkie.
You found the vehicle?
Sure. Saw it just sitting there. Strange place to be parking your car. Figured I'd better take a look. And then I saw all the blood. So I call the police.
Mind if I ask what you were doing out here?
Well, I work for the railway. I was on my way out to the switch and reckon I'd take a shortcut.
Did you see anybody else in the yard? Maybe somebody hanging around the car?
Nope. I hadn't seen a soul all day till you boys turned up.
Do you know Adrian Black, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. That ain't a name I'm familiar with.
You ever seen the car before?
Funny enough, I did. A couple of nights ago, it was over there in the parking lot. I know most of the cars are parked here regular, so it kind of stood out.
The wallet by the car. Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
Do you want the patrolman to hold you down while we turn out your pockets, Mr. Wilkie?
Maybe I checked inside that wallet. Not that I was gonna steal anything. Maybe I took a look. But there weren't no money in there. Not even change.
We found a steel pipe with blood on it near the car. Do you know anything about it, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. I went straight for the law when I saw the car was full of blood.
When you saw the blood,
Was it wet, bright red, or darker like it is now?
Darker, I'd say. Looked dry already.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Wilkie. We'll contact your employer if we need anything more from you.
If you have to, I guess. I can't really spend no more time over this.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps. If you're done here, we'll head over there now.
We're going to notify the wife. You seem to have it under control here.
Yeah, I got this.
You can drive.
Let's go introduce ourselves. You talk to her, Phelps. I'm no good at this shoulder to cry on stuff.
Just a minute.
LAPD, Mrs. Black. May we come in? We have some bad news, and we'd rather discuss this in private.
I'm Margaret Black. We can discuss this in the living room. Please come in.
Your husband drives a blue Lincoln, Mrs. Black?
That's correct.
The car has been found abandoned, and I'm afraid there are signs of foul play.
I knew something was wrong when he didn't come home.
We believe your husband may be injured. We found a pipe on the scene with blood on it.
Oh, no! My poor Adrian!
Does the name Instaheat mean anything to you, ma'am?
Yes, it does. We've just had a new water heater installed.
Whereabouts, Mrs. Black?
Just outside the kitchen window, at the side of the house.
I'd like you to try and stay calm and remember everything that you can about last night. My partner and I are going to take a look around. When you're ready, we're going to have some more questions for you. Is that okay?
Of course, officer. Anything to help secure my husband's safety.
Well, let's check the place out. Come on.
This is any use to us.
Have a good look around. There's got to be something in here to go on.
Lie down. Make yourself comfortable. So, you're a friend of Courtney's.
Yes, Doctor.
He seems very concerned about you.
I have these visions. These blinding visions. I can't get them out of my head. My skull, it feels like it's in a vice.
I want to give you something to calm your nerves. To take you on a journey back. I want you to remember
the good things about your past. Occasions that made you laugh. Times that made you smile.
Kavanaugh's. So who brought this home?
Maybe Adrian was a patron. R and I should have an address.
Incidental.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How can I help, Detective?
I need an address on a Kavanaugh's bar.
Certainly, Detective. One moment. Kavanaugh's Bar, corner of Aliso and Hewitt, south side of Union Station.
Thank you.
Everything here is going to be relevant. This is going to help us.
This was only recently installed, not 2 days ago.
Maybe it's time we took a look around outside.
Stencil, so the glasses are a match. To my Adrian. This thing gets more and more interesting. Ticket to Seattle and a suitcase gone missing.
Someone couldn't wait to get out of this house. Separate bedrooms, separate pictures. What gives here? No use leaving the thing half finished. That can't be right.
No, that won't work.
So the pipe missing from Mr. Black's heater is the same one that killed him. Huh. Seems like the assailant is a little closer to home.
Take a smarter man than me to connect that.
I'm all right now, detectives.
We found a receipt in the trunk of your husband's car for a live pig. This receipt was made out to an F. Morgan.
A pig? Adrian runs a tool business. That would be Frank Morgan. God knows what he's up to.
What makes you say that about Morgan, ma'am?
He's the foreman at my husband's plant. Very shady character. I've told Adrian he needs to keep his distance from the staff. They're always out drinking together.
Your husband frequents Kavanaugh's bar?
How did you know that? Adrian practically lives there after work.
So Adrian spends a lot of time there?
Up until recently, he's been away in Seattle a lot on business.
Did your husband tell you where he was going last night?
All he said was he was going to meet Frank for a drink.
So nothing out of the usual, then?
Well, he came home early from work. He never comes home early. And he went out early, too. He normally never leaves for the bar till about 7.
Was your husband wearing his glasses when he left here yesterday?
Yes, he just bought a new pair.
Go on.
I kept telling him to throw those old ones away. He tried to repair them with tape. They looked terrible.
I think you should come clean with us, Mrs. Black. Your husband is missing, and after our search, I'm willing to call the circumstances suspicious. Can you account for your movements last night?
You're not accusing me, are you? What an awful thing to say. I was here all night, of course, waiting for Adrian to come home.
Is there anyone who can vouch for that?
Well, no. I was here alone. I cooked Adrian's dinner and waited, but he never came home.
Tell us about the photo of Adrian in the bedroom.
What is there to tell? It's from his most recent business trip to Seattle.
There's plenty to tell. You just won't tell it. You're lying about the photograph, Mrs. Black.
You're incredibly rude and insensitive. But I guess you know that. I've told you what I know about the picture.
What about Nicole, Mrs. Black? Was your husband going to leave you for her?
I've seen the photo frame. He thinks I'm stupid. But women sense these things. I don't know if he intended to leave me or if it was just a fling. God only knows. I only want to know that he's safe.
We'll keep you informed, Mrs. Black.
Please do, Detective.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Jesus, I'm glad to be out of there.
Mr. and Mrs. Black don't seem to have the happiest home life.
He's too scared to divorce her, and she's too much of a shrinking violet to throw him out. If this hadn't happened, they could have stayed miserable together forever.
You think she could have killed him?
She sure as hell doesn't seem the type. But stranger things have happened.
Hey, I know you.
No, you don't.
That's one heck of a Sunday.
He was a five-star goddamn what?
Looking for someone?
You know Frank Morgan?
Sure. Frank's your regular. He's a loner in the back.
J.W. Robinson and
Frank Morgan?
Who's asking?
Cole Phelps, LAPD. I understand you're a friend of Adrian Black.
Yeah, I know him.
Are you aware that he's missing?
No, I hadn't heard that. Tough break.
We found Black's car abandoned in a freight depot, covered in blood. You know anything about that, Morgan?
Hell no. I'm sorry to hear that. I like Adrian. He's a good boss.
Please, don't tell me you actually believe this jerk-off, Phelps. You're lying, Morgan. You were there.
And you're talking out your ass, detective. How about you prove I was out at that rail yard?
You were there, Morgan. We found a receipt in the trunk of the car. It has your name on it. We can call the slaughter yard and nail you on it.
All right, already. That fool Adrian's falling for some dame in Seattle. He wanted me to make it look like he'd been attacked.
Where exactly is Black holed up?
No idea. I think he took off for Seattle.
Tired of your shtick, Morgan. Spill it! Or we take you out in the alley and we knock it out of you.
He's holed up at my place. He's waiting for some money to come through before he blows town.
An address?
It's an apartment house at the corner of Temple and Figueroa. Apartment number 2.
I think that's all. Thanks for your help, Morgan. We appreciate it.
Hey, I'm just glad I could help. I love cops.
Cuff him, let him go. It's up to you, Phelps. There's no way I'm writing this idiot up.
Well, if it's all the same to you, I'll go back to my drink.
That broad's got socks in the brassiere.
I've met some pretty good liars in my time. People who sound convincing because they actually believe their own bullshit. The type is clever, hard to catch out.
Frank Morgan is not one of those people.
No, he is not.
K, go ahead.
Message from Technical Services. Blood found in the abandoned Lincoln at the BE Freight Depot is not human. Repeat, not human. Compositional analysis reveals swine as the most likely match.
Roger, KGPL. Kind of reel this guy in, folks. Check the place out. Come on.
Apartment 2.
Help you, gentlemen?
LAPD detectives, Mr. Black. You're under arrest.
Look, I'm really sorry about this. I never tried to hurt anyone. I just needed to get away from L.A. I won't put up a struggle. Just let me get my things.
I knew it!
Phelps, go after him. I'll try and hit him off in the car. Remember, the gun is the last resort.
There's no point running, Adrian. Mr. Black, get back here right now. It's over, Adrian.
Stop right there, Adrian.
Why not just come clean with her, Black? Why the melodrama?
I thought it would be easier.
No, it just got a whole lot harder. Adrian Black, you're under arrest for conspiracy and fraud. We'll see what the DA has to say about wasting police resources on a wild goose chase like this.
You're gonna lose your wife, lose your job, and probably end up in the big house. I hope she was worth it, Adrian.
That turned out to be quite some case, huh? Adrian, what an idiot. You got an arrest and a clearance in your first case, and in fine style, too. Well done, detective. Efficient investigation technique, good public presence. You keep that up and you learn from Bekowsky here, you could go a long way in this department.